2021 forecast and predictions. If you are new to my channel, I'm Miss Pommy, a psychic tarot reader and accredited Reiki healer based in South Africa. Now, I am super excited for today's readings because I will be sharing with you guys a spiritual tool that I developed to help me read tarot in a more profound way. I share more about that in your readings. But for now, let's get into today's Love Being Pretty item of the day. It's a beauty item and it's this 8-hour cream skin protectant by Elizabeth Arden. Now, I received a sample size of this in high school, but I just never purchased it ever again. I have no idea why, because I love this stuff, okay? If you're looking to achieve that glossy lip trend that's going around at the moment, this is how you do it, okay? I haven't tasted the 8-hour cream, but it definitely does last. Pick this up, you will not regret it. As you saw in the intro, there are three groups for you guys to pick from, and each group is represented by a crystal. Now, in choosing a group, usually the one that catches your attention or evokes some sort of response within you is the one that carries the message for you. There is no right or wrong way of picking a group. Trust your instincts and know that the message that is meant for you will get to you. If you are interested in booking a personal tarot reading or distant Reiki healing session with me, this is the email you can use to drop me a request and I will respond within 24 hours. Thank you for spending this time with me. I'm going to go ahead and begin with Groupon's reading. If you chose the Mangana call site, then this is your December prediction and forecast. All right, we're going to start off by pulling an affirmation for the month of December for you guys. This is the only deck that I'll be shuffling on camera. Okay. So group one. For you, we have Razuli Dantor, Etheric Chords. All right. And the number 27. So I see that the month of December for you is about reflecting on the connections that you have with people and cutting cords that no longer serve you, okay? So this could be friendships. For some of you, it could be family members. Maybe you have people in your life that you're connected to who drain you or who don't necessarily help you to ascend and become a better version of yourself. So I see that you're finally gaining the strength to cut depleting and exhausting cords in the month of December, all right? And then for your affirmation, we have I am worthy, compassionate, and whole. Okay, so repeat this to yourself in the month of December. It's going to help you cut cords that drain you rather than elevate you. This is my tarot board, okay? This is a spiritual tool that I developed that is going to help me read tarot in a way that is informative, in a way that is more profound, because it helps to look at 10 different aspects of the topic that we're discussing. And today we're looking at your December forecast and predictions. You're going to see what guidance and advice comes through and what you can expect for the month of December. And we're going to see all the different aspects that are going to be affected in your life during the month of December. I'm super excited to use this board for the readings, and of course it helps bring you to a place of clarity. It offers guidance and brings total magic to your life. Your tarot messages are going to be pre-shuffled from this deck. Please know that I do not pick cards, guys. I shuffle the cards that jump out are the ones that I take and use for your reading, okay? Group one, these are your tarot cards that jumped out. Let us get into your December forecast and predictions. We start off with the King of Cups. So I see that in the month of December, you are in an emotionally stable and controlled place, okay? So this might definitely be a new feeling for you. Maybe you're somebody who struggles with anxiety, or your emotions have just been all over the place lately. Know that in December, you're coming to a calm, cool, and collected place, and you're practicing emotional maturity as well, okay? So I see you not being impulsive. Jumping to conclusions is coming forward. So maybe you were jumping to conclusions in the past, but I definitely see a lot of emotional maturity for you. And I see you being able to communicate your emotions and feelings in a way that is not destructive and impulsive, okay? A lot of emotional maturity, a lot of emotional wisdom with the crown there. So yeah, this is definitely the energy that you're moving into at the beginning of December. Or this may be something new for you, because like I mentioned, maybe you struggled with a lot of anxiety in the past, okay? And then we have the Nine of Wands. All right, I see you being in a very balanced place. And instead of being defensive, I'm channeling a major sulking vibe and being defensive and, you know, just being extra. So I see that you're coming to a calm place and you're balancing your emotional intelligence with the things that make you feel impassioned, okay? So those could be feelings of anger, frustration. You're not being quick to anger. I see you tempering your anger. I see you tempering your frustrations. And just moving to an overall emotionally intelligent and calmer place. I see you not being phased easily. As you come into emotional maturity, you're coming to much clarity as well. And, you know, you're moving to a more balanced place in the month of December when it comes to your life. Okay. Moving on into the month of December for you, Group One, I definitely see that you're putting yourself first. This is beautiful because it ties in with your affirmation of cutting cords. So I definitely see that you may have to walk away from certain connections and friendships in order to work on yourself, in order to move yourself to a spiritually elevated and grown place. I see that you're doing this in a way that is non-confrontational. I see that you're just making the decision on your own to step aside or to step back. And this may leave the people involved in a state of confusion, but know that this is necessary for you so that you figure out where your life goes from here, okay? Where are you progressing to, all right? This is coming from a place of growth is what I'm getting, okay? You're understanding that in life you need to progress, and you're also understanding that you are the creator of the reality that you wish to see. And so sometimes you may have to walk away from certain people, and in order to really not expose yourself to a lot of tension and pushback from them, you might have to do it in a way that seems selfish, but it's not really, because you're putting yourself first, and that is necessary. When you are in alignment and an abundant place, then you can really give in your connections. Then you can be a good friend, a good partner, a good child. But when you're not okay, you're just giving from an empty place and you stand to gain absolutely nothing. Okay. All right. Beautiful so far. Moving on into your reading, Group One, I see that you are opening up to new experiences, new connections, new friendships, and moving on from past connections that are draining. Okay, so you're definitely cutting cords in the month of December. I see you connecting with people who really keep you in a peaceful and stable place emotionally. And I see you being open to life and not necessarily being frustrated about the uncertainty and unpredictability of life, but you're moving to a place where you're okay and you're comfortable with that unpredictability, and you're open to experience life as it comes, okay? Absolutely beautiful. Yes, Group One, that is exactly where we want you to be, okay? So I definitely see that this is helping you move from a place of frustration, anxiety, sleepless nights, overthinking, and just being dissatisfied with the life that you live in general, okay? I definitely see that all this negative energy of the past, you're shedding it in the month of December or starting in the month of December, because I see you beginning the month of December in a very emotionally stable, calm, cool, collected, and emotionally intelligent place. All right. So know that anxiety is going to be a thing of the past, and I definitely see that it caused a lot of conflict in your life, and maybe that's why you were somebody who was just dramatic or maybe a bit impassioned or emotional, too emotional. But know that all of that is falling away, okay? There's major transformation that is occurring here, and you're moving to a place of openness, peace of mind, and tranquility in the month of December. You're sitting on your throne, and I definitely see that all this change is bringing you to a place of harmony and balance in your life. I see you having a new zest for life, being inspired, and just really enjoying the direction that your life is taking, okay? I definitely see a lot of inspiration. I see you being open. I see you being creative and really feeling like your life makes sense, because you understand that you are the creator of it, and you understand that the power lies in your hands to have the experience that you desire in life. And you understand that the friendships that you have and the connections that you have are all created by you. They're all allowed by you, okay? Nobody can force a friendship with you if that's not something that you want. So I definitely see you being in your personal power and also having a spirit of discernment, understanding what works for you and what doesn't, and not being hesitant and really trusting your intuition when it comes to the things that you discern, okay? And that is bringing you to a place of harmony. There is so much healing with regards to your heart and also just your mind. There's a lot of peace of mind that you can expect in the month of December, group one. All right, moving on into the month of December for you, group one, you're definitely emotionally smarter. So whatever happened in the past has brought you to a place of emotional intelligence, because I see you once again discerning and not just forming friendships with any Tom, Dick, and Harry. I definitely see you really reflecting and assessing any offers of friendship that come to you, and really reflecting on and assessing your past connections or your current connections, and cutting cords with those connections that no longer serve you. I also see that you're coming to a place where you understand that the current connections you have are not the be-all and end-all of your life. There are many other connections that you can form with other awesome people. So certain friendships may have to end. I see you cutting cords in the month of December. That is okay. It may not be easy, but know that it is beneficial for you, and it's time that you did what is best for you and stop trying to accommodate people all the time, because you always need to put yourself first, so that when you give to others and accommodate others, so to speak, it comes from a place of well-being and fulfillment within yourself. Okay, absolutely amazing. Group one, let's take a moment and soak this in. You are extremely abundant and in your personal power in the month of December. I see you really, really coming to an understanding of your capabilities, your potential, and really understanding that you're an asset, and that anybody who has a connection or relationship with you is lucky and blessed to have you in their life, okay? You're understanding that, and you're feeling empowered. You're sitting on your throne as you create the life that you desire, as you're restructuring, you're sweeping out the cobs, okay, the cobwebs. This is amazing, okay? And that is moving you to a place of power. You're sitting on your throne, and you're definitely just owning your personal power in the month of December, and you're feeling very abundant. You are the empress of your own throne, and you understand that nobody can throw you off course, as was the case before. Okay, now let's see how you're aligning with your purpose in the month of December 2021. I definitely see that you are in a hopeful place, okay? I see that you're moving away from an energy of pessimism, and you're moving to an energy of hopefulness and optimism for life, which is amazing, okay? I definitely see you nurturing and nourishing yourself. I see you putting yourself first, which is important because I'm hearing that this wasn't the case before. And that's why you lived in so much frustration and lack of happiness. But I definitely see that the stalk is coming in and it's bringing with it abundance and the desires of your heart. Okay, I see you healing and replenishing, hydrating and recovering. And this is aligning you with your purpose, or you're feeling aligned with your purpose. Because when you're in a place of peace and happiness, know that that is your purpose in life, to be happy and peaceful, so that you experience life to its fullest. And I definitely see there, or saw there with the Page of Cups, that you're open to the experience of life and what it brings. And you're not trying to micromanage the events in your life. If anything, you're open to the experience of life. And I see you unfolding like a lotus and just allowing the magic to unfold in your life. Now, finally, we're going to look at what is being completed and coming into fulfillment for you in the month of December, Group 1. And would you look at this? Two cards jumped out. We have the Hanged One and Death. So I definitely see that you are completing a cycle, okay? And you're moving to a place of major transformation because your entire perspective on life has changed, okay? You've moved from a place of seeing life from a very vain perspective to really seeing the deeper meaning of life. Because now you understand that you matter and that your feelings and your experience matters first before you can influence the experience of others in life. Okay, absolutely amazing. Major, major transformation. I see you moving away from the old and embracing the new, okay? And just having an entirely new perspective. I see you being enlightened as well in the month of December, which is amazing because when you're enlightened, there is no way you're not going to live a fulfilled life, okay? So I definitely see that you are completing a tough cycle. So know that anything that you've gone through that was taxing, it had to happen in order to bring you to a place of transformation, okay? In order for you to evolve, because with growth comes evolution, okay? You should be worried when you don't go through challenging times in your life, because that means that you're stagnant, you're not growing, you're not evolving. All right, Group One, that is the message I received from your tarot cards. Let's look at your oracle cards to clarify this message and see what additional insights want to come through. Group One, these are your oracle cards that came out. We're going to start with the Botanical Inspirations deck. We have Tuberose, Dangerous Pleasure. All right. The secret to reaping the greatest fruitfulness and the greatest enjoyment from life is to live dangerously. All right. Group One, I definitely see you moving to a place where you take pleasure in the things that you do and you take pleasure in your life in general. You literally enjoy the life that you live. Okay, this is absolutely beautiful. I am also getting the message that you are becoming more of a risk taker, and I saw that with the Page of Cups. You open to the experience of life and you're not so guarded. But I also see you being careful because we saw that you are discerning. Okay, you're moving into an energy where you are discerning before you act. You're not necessarily impulsive. So this is a good thing because you're moving from a state of being impulsive to a state of being open and discerning, which is amazing. And I definitely see you being very, very happy. And then we have Workaholic with the color of the throat chakra. So I definitely see that you're moving away from an energy of overthinking and doing the most, and maybe just having to defend yourself the whole time and not being authentic and just living a life that is not authentic to you, but a life that pleases others, or a life that allows you to gain validation from other people, be it friends or family. So I definitely see that you're moving away from overthinking and just doing too much and feeling like you're pushing against the current, and you're moving to a place of flowing downstream, okay? Moving with the current and living life effortlessly, okay? And that's why you're experiencing a lot of pleasure in your life. And then we have a romantic cycle begins, okay? So this is beautiful because you're beginning a new cycle in your life where self-love is the theme of your life, okay? This is absolutely beautiful. You're coming into balance, and this is reiterating the message that I said at the beginning, where you're balancing your emotions and the things that make you feel impassioned, okay? Your passions. You're coming to a perfect balance because you're exercising emotional intelligence and maturity, okay? So this is definitely a new cycle for you. I saw that with the transformation, that you're ending one cycle and entering a new cycle, and you're having an entirely different perspective of life beginning in the month of December, which is absolutely incredible. And then we have rose quartz. Open up your heart. Group one, today's messages are just syncing so beautifully, and your oracle cards perfectly clarify and intensify the message of your tarot cards. So you're opening up to life's experiences and surprises, and you're not trying to micromanage events in your life. I definitely see you being open to new experiences, but also not being impulsive. Like I said, you're very discerning and you're making emotionally intelligent choices, all right? And then for the final oracle card, to conclude your reading, we have the situation will improve. In the month of December, you're making major improvements. You're definitely healing. I see with the dolphins there. And know that support is all around you, okay? Your spiritual team is there. They are in support of you. Just because you don't see them with the physical eye does not mean that they are not there, okay? But I definitely see you being an improved version of yourself and really owning that energy and sitting on your throne. All right, group one. That is the reading I received for you. I hope it resonated in leaps and bounds. I'm sending you loads and loads of love and light in the month of December. Listen, you've got this. Continue being awesome and continue to assess and reflect, especially when it comes to the connections and friendships that you form with people, so that you only allow the connections that respect your individuality and that respect the awesomeness that you exude. All right, I will chat to you in another one. Group one, salute and bye-bye. Hello, group two, I lost my ring. Welcome to your forecast and predictions for the month of December 2021. I'm super excited for today's readings because I'm using my tarot board. This is my own creation. It's a spiritual tool that I'm going to use to do my readings so that I get more information and I can look at 10 different aspects of the topic that we are discussing. So we're going to look at 10 different aspects of the month of December 2021 for you, and we're going to see what's coming in and any insights and guidance that wants to come through. You're going to heed all of that advice. We're going to begin by pulling you an affirmation for the month of December. This is the only deck I'm going to be shuffling on camera as well. Okay, so that is your affirmation for the month of December. Let's see what came out. We have Marie Laveau, Good Juju, and the number 7, which is all about reflection and assessment, okay? You are reflecting on your past actions and making the necessary adjustments in order to attract good juju, good vibes towards you in the month of December. All right, now let's check out the affirmation in the guidebook. All I do is win. Yes, group two, look at you, look at you. All you do is win. I see positive vibes for you during the month of December. I'm crazy excited to get into your reading. Group two, these are all your tarot cards that fell out as I was shuffling. We're going to go ahead and begin with your reading. So I see that in the month of December, you are following your heart, okay? You're taking action that is inspired by your emotions, your intuition, what feels right to you. I also do see that because you are in a positive energy and just attracting positive vibes overall, there may be offers, romantic offers coming to you. So many people may be expressing their feelings towards you and, you know, maybe offering you a relationship or romantic connection. But I definitely see you being in a very positive energy and positive vibe. For some of you, you may be in the spotlight in some way, and so you're attracting a lot of attention from people who want to pursue or who have romantic interest towards you, okay, who want to pursue a romantic relationship with you. But overall, I definitely see that your good juju is coming from a place of following your heart and really trusting and being aligned with your intuition. Moving forward into the month of December for you, I definitely see that there needs to be a balance between honesty and authenticity and achieving your goals, okay? So you need to get clear when it comes to the goals that you want to achieve in life, okay? And there needs to be a perfect balance between that clarity and your endeavors, all right? It's very important for you to be honest with yourself. What path feels right and comes natural to you? What is it that you really want to do? What is it that you feel called to do? And once you reach that place of honesty and really not trying to impress others, but being authentic to your calling and being authentic to that which you feel drawn to, then know that you're going to achieve your goals with ease, okay? There's definitely going to be a duality, a relationship of duality between those two. So for some of you, I'm getting the message that there may be somebody who's coming in and expressing their true feelings for you and also the long-term goals that they envision with you, okay? Know that, of course, your free will reigns. If you feel like you want to pursue a long-term relationship with this person, they may be offering you a long-term relationship, then go ahead. Your free will reigns. Moving further into your reading, this is a beautiful card to come out in the creation and progress block of my tarot board, because the Chariot is all about progress. It's all about overcoming obstacles and keeping it moving, okay? It's all about staying in the flow. It's all about not being stagnant. It's all about not letting challenges flip you over or cause you to stagnate, all right? So I definitely see that you're making serious progress. You're overcoming challenges that maybe came to trip you or came to confuse you with regards to your path in the month of December, okay? I definitely see that you're overcoming a huge obstacle or a huge challenge or something that has just been a blockage in your life is being removed, and you're definitely progressing on to create a better experience for yourself, okay? Now, as we move on further into the year for you, group two, I definitely see that you are in control of your emotions and you are in control of the relationships that you want to enter into and the ones that you don't even want to give the light of day, all right? So the power is in your hand, especially when it comes to this romantic offer that may be coming through early on in the month, okay? Know that the power lies within you, all right? And I see you being in a very stable place and not necessarily needing a relationship or romantic connection in order to feel validated within yourself, okay? I see you being in your decisive power when it comes to romantic connections. I definitely see a lot of emotional maturity and intelligence when it comes to you, and you're not easily swayed by, you know, romantic gestures that are extravagant and over the top. Even so, you're able to ground yourself and make a decision that is emotionally wise, all right? So I definitely see that you're very comfortable with your emotional intelligence and your emotional compass. Now let's see what changes you are encountering in the month of December. Group two, this is amazing because your affirmation was all about good juju. So I definitely see that you're moving away from and acting or creating situations in your life that attract bad karma towards you, okay? So I see that you're no longer being deceptive. I just see you really being open and honest, which is amazing because we saw the Knight of Cups at the beginning, which shows you being open and honest and really not being afraid of your feelings, not being afraid of your emotions, okay? So I definitely see that you're moving away from situations and energies that make you be a terrible person or that evokes a negative reaction from you, which then causes you to attract bad juju towards yourself. So people who put you in a place where you felt like you needed to enact revenge, I see you really leaving all of that behind and understanding that all of that just came to confuse you and steer you away from your path. But I see you overcoming that obstacle, and it's more of a mental block because it has to do with your belief system, okay? It has to do with your mentality. When you believe that you need to get back at somebody who does something to you, you are now attracting bad karma because you're letting out the wrong negative vibration based off of their vibration, which essentially had nothing to do with you, even though it was directed towards you. So I definitely see that you're coming to an understanding of that entire concept and moving away from a mentality that keeps you in a cycle of bad karma, of bad juju, and you're paying no mind to any negativity because you are exuding positivity in the month of December and attracting good juju towards yourself. This is absolutely amazing. Okay, moving on into the month of December for you, I definitely see that you are healing from limiting beliefs. Once again, we spoke about this. Any negative vibration that causes you to stay stuck in a place that you're not essentially meant to be, in a place that is non-abundant, that is dark, in a place that is just filled with lack and negativity. I see you breaking away and healing from those types of limiting and self-defeating mentalities in the month of December. This is absolutely beautiful, group two. I definitely see you being in your personal power as well, and understanding that actually the person with the power here is me, and I'm going to practice emotional control, and I'm going to basically not match the energies, the negative energies that are directed towards me, but I'm going to go in the opposite direction because that is where my abundance lies, because that is where the achievement that I'm looking for lies, that is where the fulfillment of my goals lies. Okay, and because you are moving away from limiting and self-defeating beliefs and mentalities, you are expanding, you are growing, and you are moving into a very abundant place. I definitely see you reflecting on the past and how petty you've been, and how that pettiness has been keeping you away from truly living an abundant and expansively abundant life, okay? And also, as opportunities flow to you, your wisdom grows, okay? I definitely see you reflecting. I definitely see you constantly realigning your path and realigning your energies and moving to a place where you maintain that good juju, that positive energy going forward. And of course, you're attracting good juju to yourself as you let out the vibration of positivity. Major expansion, especially in terms of abundance, material wealth, guys, okay? Material possessions, definitely, okay? And it's all because you've changed your mindset and your outlook on life, and you understand that as a creator of the reality that you wish to see, you need to practice emotional maturity and emotional security and not be swayed in every direction, because in that case you have no grounding, you have no footing. Okay, so moving on further into the month of December for you, I definitely see you coming to a place of empowerment and understanding that lack and poverty, you shouldn't even be associated with any and none of those energies, all right? So I definitely see you moving into strength and personal power in the month of December and overcoming challenges of loneliness, feeling lonely and feeling needy in relationships. But mostly, there's a huge emphasis on your physical abundance, guys. You're moving away from a situation of lack. You are growing. You're growing your finances. Eight is all about willpower, empowerment, and growth and personal power increase. So your finances are definitely increasing. I have no idea what type of mentality you were carrying around, but it definitely was affecting... Ooh, we have a little bug here. But it definitely was affecting your pockets. It was affecting your bank account. It was affecting your goals. The goals that you have, there was a huge mismatch. So I definitely see you aligning. And that makes sense why the good juju card jumped out, because you are aligning with the right energies and you're moving into alignment with life force. And as you are in alignment with that abundant energy. Abundance is going to flow effortlessly towards you, and you're going to feel like you live a blessed life overall. You're going to feel like your life is filled with good juju. What was your affirmation again? Let's go back to your affirmation. Something is telling me to go back to your affirmation. All I do is win. This is your energy. This is your energy for the month of December. I see you really being taken aback and reflecting and thinking, why on earth was I keeping myself in a limited space when all I can do is win? Absolutely beautiful. I mean, come on. Group two, the ultimate fulfillment and happiness card, the 10 of cups. This is your purpose, okay? It is your purpose to be happy. It is your purpose to be fulfilled in life. Never ever doubt that, group two, okay? I see you coming to a holistic and full understanding of the fact that nobody needs to validate you in life. You need to feel validated and fulfilled within yourself. And anybody who comes in with an offer of love and wants to pursue a romantic relationship with you, then you're open to experiencing them. And whether they are there or not, it really doesn't take anything from you. If anything, they just compound your happiness because they add to a foundation that is already there and that is already solid. Okay, this is some mind-blowing stuff for you, group two. And then for the final block, which is the completion and fulfillment block of my tarot board, what is it that is coming to completion and fulfillment in the month of December? You walking away from connections that don't resonate with you, from connections that take away from you, then give back, okay? You understanding that love and connections and relationships need to be in a state of give and take. There needs to be a balance of give and take. And whenever there is a mismatch, then you know that that is an energy that you have no business in entertaining. Okay, so I definitely see you walking away from all negativity and maintaining your positive vibe, maintaining your good juju in the month of December. All right, group two, that is the reading I received from your tarot cards. Now let's look at your oracle cards and see what messages are being reiterated, clarified, and heed any further guidance and advice that wants to come through. Group two, these are your oracle cards. We're going to begin by looking at the Botanical Inspirations deck. The first card we have is Hydrangea, thankfulness for understanding, okay? Before we can forgive one another, we have to understand one another. Group two, I see you coming to a place of letting go of connections that no longer serve you and understanding why they came into your life, what they came to teach you. And because you understand the lesson, you're able to let go with ease. Okay, I definitely see you letting go. And that is the thing about forgiveness, right? Forgiveness is the act of letting go. Okay, letting go of past hurts and being in a place of freedom, being in a place of ease and alignment. Okay, with the energy of abundance, which is life force energy that is creative and loving in its nature and abundant in its nature. Okay, so I definitely see you living a life of gratitude because you've come to an understanding of your personal power to create and an understanding of the relationships that you keep and don't keep in your life because you have that emotional maturity and intelligence. And also, I want you to note before we get further into your reading that you chose the clear quartz. Okay, this is usually a stone that is associated with the crown chakra, and the crown chakra is where you house your mentality, your belief systems, okay, your connection to the divine. So I definitely see that you are clearing negative and self-limiting beliefs, as we saw there with the harmony and healing, and you're healing your mindset and you are aligning, you're flowing in harmony with the life force energy that creates, that is abundant in its nature. Okay, absolutely beautiful. Wow, look at this. You are rejecting all negativity and limiting mentalities. And this is interesting because I do see that a lot of them were because of external influences in your environment, okay? A lot of that stuff that caused you to be in this situation of self-limitation is due to your environment, okay? The people you kept around you. For some of you, these may be limiting beliefs that were solidified within you during your childhood as you were growing up. But know that the beautiful thing about life is that we grow, and growth is a beautiful thing because it allows you to move past tough situations. It allows you to always pursue a better version of you, okay? That is the beautiful thing about growth, all right? As you grow, you move into more personal power. And then we have work through your fears, new moon in Scorpio, all right? So I definitely see that you're working through your fears, especially when it comes to lack and abundance and feeling like you're afraid of not being provided for. I see you working through that fear and coming into empowerment and personal power as you create, as you see yourself manifest the abundance that you desire, as you see your goals come to fruition. I see you working through all those fears because they're coming from a place of limiting and self-defeating beliefs. And because of this, you're becoming a deeper person. Okay, so let's read what it says there. Once you're on earth for enough lifetimes, your old soul will begin to long for non-grasping, detachment and surrender. They bring the peace of God. Yeah, I definitely see you being in a peaceful place and really understanding the depth of your connection to the divine, understanding that the energy that flows through you, the life force energy that flows through you, is abundant. And because you are constantly and integrally connected to that life force energy, there is no way you will not be abundant. There is no way that you cannot manifest each and every one of your goals. So I definitely see you coming to a spiritually deep place and really understanding the deeper meaning of life and not seeing things at face value. Okay, I love the message of non-grasping, detachment and surrender, because I definitely see you being in a place where you don't hold on to things. You let things go because you understand that any negative energy has nothing to do with you. I see you practicing once again emotional control and intelligence. You are in the driver's seat. This is absolutely beautiful. And because of that, you're attracting good juju in terms of relationships, in terms of finances, in terms of career, just any aspect that is associated with your long-term goals. You are attracting good juju and you're seeing those things come into fruition, and you're seeing the profoundness of letting go of self-limiting and self-restricting and defeating thoughts. And then the final oracle card for your reading, which tells us more about the month of December for you, 2021, group two. You are choosing a new direction in life. You've come to the realization that the direction you were going in honestly was not for your highest good. And you understand that you can do so much more. And you also understand that you deserve so much more. All right. And because of that, you're choosing a new direction, and you're choosing the direction of abundance, of growth, of progress and success, of achievement, of emotional control, of following your heart, and of letting love in that only amplifies and emphasizes your self-worth. Okay. And I see you being very happy and fulfilled, and all these things are aligning you with your purpose in life, which is to be happy and profoundly and absolutely happy at that. All right, group two, those are your December forecast and predictions for the year 2021. I hope this reading resonated in leaps and bounds. All right, be sure to follow me on my Instagram at lovebeingpretty so that you don't miss out on my week ahead readings, which I post as a story every Sunday. I am sending you loads and loads of love and light. Listen, Stay in alignment with good juju always. You have absolutely nothing to lose. I will chat to you in another one. Salute and bye-bye. Hello, Group 3. Welcome to your December 2021 forecast and predictions. Okay, I'm super excited for today's readings because I'm using my tarot board. This is a spiritual tool I created to help me give more profound and informative, totally magical tarot readings, okay? It allows me to look at 10 different aspects of the topic we are discussing. Group 3, to begin your reading, I'm going to pull you an affirmation for the month of December, okay? So this is the only deck I'll be shuffling on camera. All the other cards are pre-shuffled to save time. Same as Group 1, we have Razuli Dantor, Etheric Quartz, the number 27. So I definitely see that the month of December for you is about cutting toxic cords, okay? So let's get into the guidebook for your affirmation. We have, I am worthy, compassionate, and whole. So repeat this to yourself so that you align with the energies that recognize your worthiness, that appreciate your compassion, and that already recognize that you are whole and fulfilled, and they only come to experience you, not to complete you. Group 3, these are your tarot cards. I've pre-shuffled them. Know that I don't pick cards. I see some of them because they flip over, and then the rest I don't see, okay? I just channel as I go along. And I just want to mention that you were drawn to the garnet crystal, okay? Which is all about passion, passion, passion. So I'm expecting a lot about passion here. And passion is not necessarily like you feeling inspired or in love with something or someone, but it's also about negative energies, feelings of anger, grudges, frustration, etc. So let's see what comes out in your tarot cards. So we begin with death, okay? So this is definitely a new energy that is coming in for you in the month of December, Group 3. I definitely see that you're leaving something behind and embracing the new, okay? But I'm getting that this may not be the easiest transition or transformation for you. You may feel defeated. You may feel like life is happening to you and not necessarily for you, but know that anything that you perceive as tough or challenging is definitely happening for you. It is to align you with your purpose in life and also to bring you to a place of fulfillment and happiness, okay, and growth and evolution, which is very, very important. So I definitely see that there is major transformation. Moving further into your reading, Group 3, two cards jumped out for the duality and balance blocks. So let's see what they are. All right. Okay, so I definitely see that you're moving to an abundant place because you're overcoming obstacles, okay? You're not letting your obstacles defeat you. You're not letting the tough times defeat you. Most importantly, you're not letting uncertainty get in your way, okay? So I definitely see you pushing through, exercising willpower and pushing through the challenges. And because of that, you're earning your throne. Because of that, you're coming into the understanding of your abundant nature. You're very abundant is what I see. And you're understanding that you have so much creativity that lies within you, and that creativity is being expressed, okay? So there's a lot of progress, movement, success as you own your power, as you push through the challenges, okay? Very, very important. Moving further into your reading, I can definitely see that there's a new energy within you. There is this will to fight, to stand up for what you believe in, to stand your ground and to no longer entertain the feeling of being defeated in the month of December, okay? So I definitely see that moving forward, you are progressing to an energy of strength, to an energy of resilience, and really understanding that the power lies in your hands and any outside influence should never put you in a place where you feel completely defeated and totally knocked out. All right. And I see that this is because you have been taking too much comfort in your pain, in the energy of feeling defeated, in the energy of just lying there and saying everything is fine and allowing all this hurt and pain to just pierce through you and really dwelling in it. I see that you've been taking too much comfort and shelter within this energy. And in the month of December, no more. You're standing up and you're fighting. You're fighting to be better. You're fighting to be happy. You're fighting to be optimistic, healthy, and positive, which is absolutely amazing. You are no longer finding comfort in the pain. You're no longer finding comfort in the defeat, but you're finding comfort in the strength. You're moving forward. You're progressing. You are chasing success. And because of that, you're coming into so much abundance, group three, which is absolutely amazing, I might add. Okay, so I definitely see that the conflicts in your life were because people did you dirty. Okay, let's talk about this. People did you dirty. They certainly did. And I just feel like I'm sensing a very pure soul. You're genuine, you know, and when you care about someone, you care genuinely. And I'm seeing that, you know, you've been done dirty. You've experienced a lot of rejection and deceit. And, you know, a lot of the times you really don't understand what you did to deserve all this rejection and deceit, because you've literally given your all. Okay, you need to understand, right, group three, that people have blocked energy centers, their chakras, okay, and people need to heal. So whenever somebody does something to you that is of a low vibration, any negative action, negative thought, a negative spoken word is a low vibrational energy. When somebody extends that towards you, it is never, ever, ever about you and always about them. Okay, they are blocked, and it's up to you to discern that energy and not take it and own it and make it your own, because when you do, then you take on a lot of unnecessary pain and you will be defeated and you will be depleted. Okay, so it's very, very important for you to be able to discern and understand that their pain has nothing to do with you. They are hurting because they are blocked and they are attracting more and more hurt, and hurt people hurt people. That's just the cycle. Okay, you are your energy profile. So if you hurt, you're going to hurt. If you choose to not heal, you're going to exude the energies of non-healing, low vibrational energies, anger, frustration. You're going to want to hurt people. So it's very important for you to understand that whatever was done to you, whatever deceit you experienced, whatever unfair treatment you experienced, had nothing to do with you. Don't take that and hold it and allow it to become the foundation of your life, because you're going to experience lack. You're going to experience pain. You're going to experience heartache and frustration. Okay, you're going to experience defeat. So understand that all of that had nothing to do with you, and do your healing. Okay, do your healing and move to a better place. Adopt a new mentality and mindset, where you are optimistic, where you are positive, where you are happy in life. Okay, where you entertain the fact, not even the idea, the fact that happiness is your purpose in life, and you live in complete and absolute pursuit of happiness. Okay, so I definitely see that in December you are strong enough to change the mentality of defeat, of feeling like life happens to you, and anticipating rejection and heartache and pain. I see you moving into your personal power and taking ownership and understanding that other people's energy has nothing to do with you. Your energy has everything to do with you, and that is your focus going into the month of December. For the harmony and healing block of my tarot board, three cards jumped out for you. So we're going to get into each and every one of them, starting with the Four of Pentacles. Okay, absolutely, absolutely just profound is the word I'm looking for, because you need to heal. You are holding on. You are holding on to so much, group three. My chest is almost sitting on my lap. I feel so heart heavy. It is crazy. You are holding on to so much. And that's why I mentioned at the beginning that the crystal that you chose already tells me that there is a lot of fiery, passionate energy here. And while I'm seeing that, it's energy that is not necessarily good, but you're making the transformation in December, okay? Because we have transformation as the first card that jumped out for the first block, newness and beginning. You're letting go of all this anger, grudge, negativity, defeat that you're holding on to. I don't necessarily get a lot of anger. I get a lot of self-loathing, victim mentality, everything is fine, defeated, oh, I'm a doormat type vibe. No, you need to heal that, okay? And I see you healing that and getting up and fighting in the month of December. Believe it, believe that you are. And look at this, we have confirmation of that card, double energy, the Ten of Swords. You need to no longer take comfort in this energy. Group three, come on. You're holding on to the pain, you're holding on to the defeat. And when you do this, it is because you're living in the past. You need to let go of the past. You need to let go of the past. You need to cut the cord. You have developed a cord to the pain. You've developed a cord to the defeat. You've developed a cord to the heartache. You've developed a cord to the suffering. It's very important for you to cut that cord. You have the power to. Okay, you have the power to, because what was your affirmation again? I am worthy, compassionate, and whole. You need to understand, group three, that you are worthy of happiness. Okay, and you are worthy to find people and enter relationships where there is a balance of give and take when it comes to the love you give, your compassion, the compassion that you extend towards the other party. You're worthy of a relationship that reciprocates that. You're worthy of a relationship that doesn't complete you, but that understands that you're already complete within yourself, and it just emphasizes that about you, okay? Whew, group three, very, very heavy energy. Okay, so I definitely see we are still on the harmony and healing block of my tarot board. I see that you holding on to all this negative energy, all this pain, all this pessimism, all this negativity, anticipating hurt and pain and defeat and rejection. It is putting you in a state of confusion, and you're not able to listen to your intuition. You're not able to listen to your inner wisdom and guidance. And that is a problem. That is a problem, because how do you expect to move to an abundant place? We saw with the Empress here. How do you expect to move to an abundant place if you hold on to all this negative energy that is keeping you in a state of confusion? Don't be fooled by negativity. Do not be fooled by negativity, okay? But this is amazing, because I saw there with the Chariot that you are overcoming this huge obstacle. You're overcoming the hold, you're overcoming this cord, you're cutting this cord once and for all that you have been holding on to, and that you've been finding a lot of comfort within, okay? Moving on further into your reading, I see that you're making an entire and complete shift. There is major change happening here, and we saw that with the transformation at the beginning. You are reflecting on the past and moving from a place of being at the bottom and feeling defeated and feeling trampled on to being on top and understanding your worth and personal power. Okay, so this is amazing, because in the month of December, you are reflecting on the past, you're taking the lessons of the past, and you are sitting on top, okay? You're not letting the wheel run you over, you are in control of the wheel. All right, how beautiful is this? This is absolutely amazing. Group three. Why do you let people do this to you? You're not supposed to give away your power like this, okay? And then we have the Queen of Pentacles. Yes, moving on to positive vibes. So I definitely see that the year is starting off on a positive but difficult note for you, because, you know, getting up and doing something about your mindset, your beliefs, and really getting aligned with high vibrational energies may not be the easiest things at times, but that is because you are you're pushing against the current. That is because you're swimming upstream rather than downstream. Okay. As you learn to let the pain go, as you learn to let all of that pessimism and negative energy go, it becomes easier with time. You are moving on to expansion of willpower, of self-empowerment, expansion of self-esteem, self-worthiness. This is the energy that you're moving to. Okay. The month of December is going to be very, very profound for you. We started off with a major arcana card, the Death card, which is transformation. We have the Wheel of Fortune, which is also a major arcana card, and this talks about changes, positivity flowing to you. So I definitely see that you are concluding a difficult chapter, you are transforming and becoming a renewed version of yourself, because you are keeping it moving and overcoming obstacles, and you are aligned with your personal power. That is amazing. And your self-worth and empowerment is expanding, your self-esteem, you're feeling more empowered as well, which is lovely. Okay, let's move further into your reading. Group three, we have the Page of Swords. Okay, so with this card, I see that you are aligning with your purpose in a beautiful way, and you're coming into a lot of learning and understanding of what your purpose truly is on this plane of existence. Okay, so the tough times were not for nothing. Do you see this? They're not for nothing. You literally have reached rock bottom, and the only way to go from rock bottom is up. You can only rise from rock bottom. Okay, so I see you learning more about your purpose, coming into more knowledge, and really understanding how abundant, how important you are on this plane of existence, and seeing the greater scheme of things rather than adopting other people's energies and allowing them to keep you in this energy of confusion. And look at what is happening. Look at how we are ending this reading. Look at the vibration and the energy that you are coming to. Group three, the Nine of Pentacles. Okay, you're feeling complete and fulfilled to the point where you start enjoying life, and you enjoy the little things in life that give you pleasure, the little things in life that mean something to you. Okay, you're building a very abundant life for yourself, and you're doing it with ease because you're coming into that wisdom of understanding that happiness is your purpose, and any energy that does not come to raise your vibration. What energies raise your vibration? Anything positive, joy, happiness, fulfillment, excitement, any action that comes to make you feel happy, joyful, excited, motivated. Those are high vibrational energies, and those are energies that align you with your purpose in life, which is to be happy, because happiness, contentment, fulfillment, gratitude, those are extremely high vibrational energies. And when you resonate at that level, you're going to align with life force energy, which is the power that creates within us. It's the power that created our universe. It's the power that creates worlds. When you are in alignment and flow with that energy, it is abundant in its nature. So there is no way you are not going to be abundant. Okay. So understand that you are coming to an amazingly high vibrational place and energy in your life, where life feels effortless, where you feel like you are swimming downstream and moving with the flow of the current rather than upstream. Okay, but it's very important for you to get up and take inspired action towards the goals that you want to manifest, towards the life that you want to see. What you send out is what comes back. That is the universal law of attraction. So when you are in a negative energy state, that's what you're sending out. And what do you think you're going to manifest? What do you think is coming back to you? Negativity in all its glory. I'm not even kidding. You're going to manifest more pain, more situations that compound the feeling of rejection and defeat within you. Change this mindset. Get up and fight. I already see you doing this, and know that you will overcome each and every obstacle that comes to try and knock you down. Okay, You're going to overcome all of that with ease, and you're going to be in a very happy, abundant place aligned with life force energy, and really live in gratitude and appreciation of the life that you have created for yourself and designed. That is the reading I received from your tarot cards, group three. Let's get into your oracle cards now. These are your oracle cards. We're going to first look at the Botanical Inspirations deck and see what came out. Sweet William, gallantry, grant me a single smile. Sweet William Small has form and aspect bright, like that sweet flower that yields great Jove delight. Listen, in the month of December, you have a reason to smile. Group three, what are you doing to me? My heart is so heavy. I'm struggling to breathe. Okay, if you don't know, get to know. I am clairvoyant, clairsentient, and clairaudient, which means I psychically see, feel, and hear your energy. Okay, listen. You're going to have a reason to smile definitely in the month of December. But it's very important for you to get up, take inspired action, and be proactive in achieving joy, in achieving great Jove delight, okay? You need to get up from this dump. You need to. And the month of December is the month in which you do this, okay? So that you have a reason to smile. And then we have service, the color of the sacral chakra. It's very important for you to be of service to yourself. Group three, you need to be of service to yourself. You need to take care of yourself. You need to nurture yourself, because this is not on, okay? This is not on is what I'm hearing. This is not on. You need to come to a place of replenishment, which is very important. You need to move to a place of passion once again. Now look at this. The sacral chakra is all about our passion in life, our passion to create, our passion to be inspired, our passion to be creative. And you chose the garnet crystal. You felt drawn to this crystal, which is all about enhancing our passions. It works with the sacral chakra to help you clear the sacral chakra and enhance your feelings of passion and zest for life. So it's very, very important for you to be of service to yourself, so that you revive the things that made you feel passionate and optimistic about life. Group three, okay? And you do this by being proactive, by getting up and taking that wand and fighting for the future that you wish to see. All right. And by fighting, I'm not saying get up and push against the current. You already don't want to be in this energy. You are already pushing up the current. All I'm asking you is to get out of that current by entertaining a positive energy, by smiling, by focusing on all the positive things, on all the things that are going right in your life, because then you will stop magnifying all the things that are going wrong. Okay, absolutely beautiful. And then the next card we have is outrageous openness. Dear love, open me to your will. Release me from my attachments. Release me from my attachments. Surprise and delight me with your plan. You know what's needed, and I'm open to receive. Group three, you need to move to a place of outrageous openness, and let go. Release yourself from the attachments that you have to all this negativity, because we saw here on the tarot board that you're taking comfort in this negative energy. You need to open yourself up to a different reality than the one you are currently experiencing. And I see that you have the strength to do this. And December is the month to begin if you haven't already. Okay, but I definitely see December turning out to be absolutely amazing and filled with pleasure and passion for you. Okay, and then we have ask for help from others. Listen, help is all around you. Help is all around you. You also have service, okay? You can get help. I'm not so getting professional help, but if that resonates with you, you can get professional help to help you. You maybe talk, get things out, you know, to help. Talking helps. It helps to release all that clogged up energy. You may need to get help in terms of booking a Reiki session. Okay, I do offer distant healing Reiki, but if you feel like you want somebody to be there physically for you, then, you know, go to Google and see where you can find a Reiki healer near you. What a Reiki healer does is they help to clear your energy centers and help you with the release of negative energy so that you realign with life force energy, so that you're able to release negativity with ease and move into a positive vibration where you attract high vibrational energies and live an abundant life overall. Okay, so if you want to book a session with me, the email is in my description box, lovebeingpretty@gmail.com. And with this card, we conclude your reading. Group three, we have Angelite. Support is all around you. Would you look at this? Would you look at this? Support is all around you. So ask for help. Ask for help. It is not a mistake that you are receiving this reading here today. Okay, your guides and your angels really want you to know that support is available for you. Group three, reach out, stand up, do something, take inspired action, be proactive, because support is all around you. Okay, your divine team is there. You can ask for support from your angels. You can ask for support from your guides and ancestors. They are there, guys. We make the mistake of thinking that once our loved ones pass on, and also the entities that we don't see with the physical eye, like angels and guides, we make the mistake of thinking they don't exist. They so do exist. The only thing is they resonate at a higher frequency. So that's why you don't see them with your physical eye, because the physical state of being is a low vibrational energy compared to their form of existence. When your loved ones pass on, they transcend to a higher vibrational energy and they see so much more than they could with the physical eye. They come into so much knowledge and so much enlightenment, and they are there to help you. They're not going to desert you now that they've passed on. If they were supportive and loving of you whilst they were incarnated physically here on earth, that love is going to be compounded when they transcend to spiritual form. Okay, so it's very important for you to understand that you have an amazing support system. They are here confirming it for you. Ask for help, reach out, ask for guidance. You will receive it. Okay, group three, super heavy energy, but I'm beginning to feel light. That is confirmation that you're moving to a lighter feeling in the month of December, and you're raising your vibration. This is the reading I received for you. I hope it resonated in leaps and bounds. Listen, you have nothing to lose. Support is all around you, and transformation is a big theme for you in the month of December. Head on over to my Instagram and follow me so that you don't miss out on my week ahead stories that I post every Sunday. I'm sending you loads and loads of love and light. Group three, you will heal and you will move on to being an amazing version of yourself. Salute and bye.